Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the 7-point plan for the guidance. This topic is related with the guidance and counseling in context with the education. So basically this plan was developed by Alec Rodger in 1952 for the National Institute of Industrial Psychology, London. The main purpose was about the human resource management in the industrial area. But later on, the same plan has been applied in education system. Now, Alec Rodger given those 7 points that we are going to discuss in the context of education. So he has given 7 points. So as a teacher, when you want to guide the student regarding his issues, you should know this kind of information, this kind of data about the student before guiding them. And though these points are different, but still it should be considered in a totality. Just matter of the understanding, the 7 points are differently given, but otherwise this should be studied holistically. So one by one, let us see what are the points. So before you going to guide a student, you should know the physical makeup. It means his health and his external personality. Second, attainment, like in which standard she is, what remarks she got generally by teachers, how is her report card, and how is her curricular performance. So how she is totally in her scholastic studies. Third is general intelligence. How is her IQ? How is her common sense? Overall smartness. It should be studied before giving a guidance to her. Next, the special aptitude. That is how she is special in something. Like she must be, it's different from the hobbies, it's different from the interest, is the aptitude. Like if she is good in mechanical, or good she is in sports, or she is good in read some intellectual work, so that should be known. Fifth is interest, like the hobbies, the likings, like and it can be reflected by her curricular co-curricular performance. You need to see whether she is participating in different curricular activities, co-curricular activities, extracurricular activities to collect this kind of information. Sixth, disposition is, we can say it's the nature of a person. So you need to observe students and need to see whether she is dependent, or she is independent or self-relying. In that way you need to see her total behavior, and you need to collect the data about her nature. Next is circumstances, last one. So this is about the socio-economical background of the students, family background. So you need to collect this information of the student. So it means overall, when you want to guide any student, you need to collect this kind of information from the student. Physical features, then her curricular progress, then her general intelligence, the smartness and the special aptitude, and her any interest and nature, disposition and some circumstances. So before guiding a student, you need to collect such kind of information about the student. So generally when we guide them for personal purpose, for vocational purpose, we need to collect all these interrelated information from the student. So some of the points can be elaborated by the interaction of the student, and sometimes you need to observe the student behavior and collect the student behavior in these 7 points, and at the end all the points should be looked at together. Teacher are supposed to combine all the points and need to guide the student on the basis of these 7 points. And teachers should be careful about collecting the information about the students. The data collection tools should be reliable. Okay, when you are asking someone, you should be very objective. So if the data itself is incorrect, so your guidance will be even misguiding to the student. So carefully collect all the 7 points data from the students, about the students, and guide the students according to her need. These are the 7 points all together. So it basically says you understand your students holistically and then only guide. Thank you.